I started my career is that I stayed true to myself and followed my passions. So my passion today is really driven by three words: imagine, inspire, and innovate. If we imagine what is in the realm of the possible and be inspired to really make a difference, then we can innovate around a set of solutions. I always say, you know, please be true to yourself and find your passion.
One of the smartest things I did early in my career, fortunately, was to learn to listen to others. I had great mentors, gave great advice, and one of the best things that I did was I learned early on to volunteer as much as possible. A lot of my leadership experiences early on was managing volunteers. So if you're volunteering and managing volunteers, that's a big challenge. And just appreciating them, folks, for what they bring to the table and making sure that they understand how much they're appreciated for what they're doing is something that conveys every day where I'm at now.
When I started my career, I'm going to say when I got out into commercial world out of the military, and I was very binary. I found a mentor who was in many ways the opposite of me, so he helped draw me out and understand that there were complementary skills that you had to have to kind of soften your outlook, look at the whole problem, approach it a little bit differently other than binary right or wrong or one way to do things or following orders. So I found the complementary skills in a mentor to soften my rough edges. That was probably the best thing I've done.
So probably not the smartest thing I did starting my career, but as I started out as a leader, as a woman leader, I thought I had to be 100% on all the time, 100% professional. I kept my work life and my professional life very separate. But I realized in doing that, that you're not really being an authentic leader, that your struggles, your successes, your vulnerabilities are what makes you you. And that is important to bring to everything you do. People relate to someone that they can admire and respect and trust, but also that they can relate to as struggling with some of the same things that they're struggling with. And so I realized that being an authentic leader really helped me build myself as a leader, as a woman, but also as a trusted advisor in the firm.
When I think back to the start of my career, I think the smartest thing that I have done is I was intentional about that career. What I mean by intentional is that I was purposeful with my thoughts and with my actions. I envisioned the next step. I spoke to people about that next step, and I took action. The advice that I now give to those that I mentor, to those that I work with, to those that seek it out, is to be intentional about your career. Think about where your next steps are and devise a plan to get there.